Dear students, today we will discuss about resonance effect. Resonance effect, that is between alternate pi bonds, or you can say conjugated system. That is, single and double bond are present at alternate position in a carbon compound. Or it may be between pi bond and non-bonding electron at adjacent atoms. When pi bond and non-bonding electron, you can say lone pair of electron present at adjacent atom, then the resonance effect occurs. In resonance effect, there is transfer of pi electron density. In inductive effect, there is transfer of sigma electron density. But in resonance effect, there is transfer of pi electron density, and it is also a permanent effect. Now, resonance effect is of two types, plus R effect and minus R effect. Plus R effect, when an atom or substituent gives the electron density to the pi bond, when it is adjacent to the, when it is present at adjacent position to the pi bond and it gives the electron density to the pi bond, then it is said to have plus R effect. For example, halogens, all halogens, hydroxy, alkoxy, primary amino group, secondary, tertiary, as well as esters, all groups are supposed to have plus R effect because all these groups have lone pair of electrons on them which they can easily donate. For example, we have taken the example of vinyl chloride. Vinyl chloride, here chlorine atom having three lone pairs present at adjacent position to the carbon atom having pi bond, double bond, or you can say pi bond. So electron movement occurs from this chlorine atom, lone pair gets transferred here, and then pi bond shifts to this carbon. So since electron density is being transferred towards the pi bond, that's why it is supposed to have plus R effect. As a result of this, there will be double bond between this carbon and chlorine and positive charge on the chlorine atom. Because why positive charge? You see, here chlorine was having 2 to 4 to 6 and 1 is shared, 7 electron, and chlorine is having 7 valence electrons. But after donating the lone pair, now it is having 2 to 4 and 2 6. 6 electrons in its valence shell, that's why 1 positive charge. And now this carbon will have the negative charge because pi bond gets shifted to this carbon atom. Now these are the two resonating structures for vinyl chloride. And I tell you that resonating structures are shown by having a two-headed arrow in between. This arrow indicates that these two are the resonating structures. So this is the example of plus R effect. Similarly, you can also have the example of vinyl alcohol also, where lone pair from OH group get transferred towards the pi bond. Second, minus R effect. Minus R effect, when an atom or substituent withdraws electron density from the pi bond, it takes the electron density towards itself. When such a group is there, that it takes the electron density towards itself from the pi bond, pi bond electron density gets transferred towards the atom or the substituent attached. Then it is minus R effect. For example, aldehydic, carboxylic, ketonic, nitro and cyano. When these groups are attached to an atom having pi bond, when these groups are attached adjacent to the carbon atom having pi bond, they withdraw the electron density towards themselves and are said to have minus R effect. For example, I have taken where aldehydic group is attached to the adjacent to the carbon having pi bond. So this, since you know carbonyl group and electron withdrawing group, so it withdraw the electron density from this carbon atom. So pi bond gets shifted towards it, towards this aldehydic group attached. That's why it is having minus R effect. So pi bond shifts here, then it shifts towards the oxygen. So as a result of it, we have this second as the resonating structure of it, where now oxygen is having the negative charge and this carbon is having the positive charge. How positive and negative charge come? I have already told you, because one of the electron becomes less in the valence shell, then it is having positive charge. If one electron increases, then it is having the negative charge.